In these examples, we're given a polynomial. We want to identify the greatest common factor and then factor the polynomial. Well, the greatest common factor of a polynomial is the largest monomial that would divide evenly into each term. To do this, there's two steps in the process. We first want to find the greatest common factor of the coefficients, or in this case, 18, 6, and 24. And then we have to identify the greatest common factor of the variable factors, in this case, x to the fifth, x to the fourth, and x to the third. So if you can analyze these terms and know the greatest common factor is going to be 6x to the third, that's great. But if you can't, one method for doing this is to write the coefficients in prime factored form and then expand the variable factors. Once we do this, we can just identify all the factors they have in common, which would give us the greatest common factor. So looking at 18, we could write this as 2 times 9, and 2 is prime. We can write 9 as 3 times 3, which are both prime. So we could write 18x to the fifth as 2 times 3 times 3. And then for x to the fifth, we'd have 5 factors of x. The prime factorization of 6 would be 2 times 3, which are both prime. So we'd have plus 2 times 3 times 4 factors of x. And for the prime factorization of 24, well, 24 is 4 times 6. 4 is 2 times 2. Both prime, and 6 would be 2 times 3, both prime. So we'd have plus 3 factors of 2, 1 factor of 3, and 3 factors of x. And now that it's in this form, we can highlight all the factors they have in common. Notice how they all contain a factor of 2, as well as a factor of 3. This tells us that 6 is the greatest common factor of 18, 6, and 24. Notice that each of them also contain 3 factors of x. Which means x to the third is the greatest common factor of x to the fifth, x to the fourth, and x to the third. Notice how when dealing with the variable factors, the lowest exponent on the variable is going to be the greatest common factor of the variable part. So this tells us the greatest common factor is equal to 6x cubed, which means we can factor the polynomial by writing this as 6x cubed times the factors that would remain after factoring this out of each term. Well, going back to our work, if we factor out the highlighted factors, we're left with the factors that are not highlighted. So for the first term, we'd be left with 3x to the second plus, here we'd be left with just x, plus here we're left with just 2 times 2, or 4. So here's our greatest common factor, and here's the polynomial in factored form. So writing this out in this form does take a little bit of work, but it does guarantee we'll identify the greatest common factor correctly, and also help us write it in factored form. Let's take a look at one more example. Again, our first step, we want to determine the greatest common factor of 60, 15, and 45, and then identify the greatest common factor of a to the fourth, b to the third, a to the third, b to the fourth, and a to the second, b to the fifth. For this example, we won't expand the variable factors, but we will write the coefficients in prime factored form. So for 60, we'd have 6 times 10, 6 would be 2 times 3, 10 is 2 times 5, so we have 2 factors of 2, a factor of 3, and a factor of 5. So we'll have 2 times 2 times 3 times 5, a to the 4th, b to the 3rd, minus the prime factorization of 15 would be 3 times 5. So we'd have 3 times 5 times a to the 3rd, b to the 4th, plus 45 would be 9 times 5, and 9 is 3 times 3. So we have 3 times 3 times 5 times a to the second, b to the fifth. Okay, so now we're going to identify the greatest common factor of the coefficients. Notice how they all contain a factor of 3 and a factor of 5. So the coefficient of the greatest common factor is going to be 15. And then to identify the greatest common factor of the variable factors, Here we have 4 factors of a, 3 factors of a, and 2 factors of a. So they all have 2 factors of a in common, so a to the second would be part of the greatest common factor. And then here we have b to the third, b to the fourth, and b to the fifth. So they all have 3 factors of b in common, so we have b to the third. Remember, the greatest common factor of the variable factors would be the lowest exponent on the common base. So now we'll factor this out of our polynomial. So this is equal to 15a to the second, b to the third, and then we'll see what's left when we factor this out of each term. We'll factor out 15 from 60, we're left with 4. Then we're factoring out 2 factors of a, so we'll have a squared. Then we're factoring 3 factors of b out, so there are 0 factors of b left. Minus, notice how we're factoring the 15 out, so the coefficient would be 1, which we can leave off. And we're factoring out 2 factors of a, so we have 1 extra factor of a. We're factoring out 3 factors of b from b to the fourth, so we have 1 factor of b. Plus, and from the last term, we have a factor of 3 left. And then again, we're factoring out 2 factors of a, so there's no factors of a left. And then we're factoring out 3 factors of b from b to the fifth, so we'd have b to the second. So this would be the polynomial in factored form. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.